Chapter 174, The Honor Tutor's Difficult Problem and Promise. The old tutor's response actually wasn't what Yi Dai had hoped for. In fact, Yi Dai had really wanted the honor tutor to compliment him and say that he'd asked a wonderful question, and then compliment him on his scope of vision and desire to find high footing. Finally, he would also encourage Yi Dai to use this goal as motivation and strive to achieve it. Unfortunately, these were all answers that Yi Dai craved, but the old tutor's actual response was vastly different. However, Yi Dai didn't dare show the slightest bit of dissatisfaction, so he put on a facade of being deep in thought. He mused for a bit before saying, "The teacher's words are full of determination aimed at a higher vantage point. Your student will need to advance to another level before being able to comprehend the teacher's perspective. It looks like your student will need to work harder at grasping the greater picture, and must at the same time desire to become a fierce and ambitious person, working towards the goal of uniting the 16 kingdoms." Although the honor tutor hadn't responded in the way he hoped, this didn't preclude Yi Dai from expressing his own opinions and views towards the honor tutor. The Lord Master smiled faintly and didn't respond. He would only answer a question once, and it was impossible for him to voice anything else. Although Danf maintained a natural smile on her face, she was shaking her head inwardly. Yi Dai fancied himself as a clever man. How would a young man like Yi Dai be able to grasp the perspective from which the honor tutor viewed things? Danf could actually understand what the Lord Master meant with his words. He was saying that the momentum for a greater picture to unite the 16 kingdoms had yet to form. He was also hinting that Yi Dai was not the fierce and ambitious talent that was needed. That last sentence in particular, in which all was empty talk if both of the requisite conditions weren't met, was actually a blow to Yi Dai. It was an oblique indication he should stay grounded and humble, and refrain from reaching for what was beyond his grasp. It was a pity that Yi Dai was completely immersed in his own thoughts and had not understood the connotations of the honor tutor's words. "What heights have you risen to now to speak of uniting the 16 kingdoms? Your strength has yet to reach the required level, but your ambitions are overweening. This would wreck the country and bring ruin to the people." In the end, Yi Dai still thinks of himself as a bit more clever than he actually is. Danf sighed privately within her heart. Her beautiful eyes changed direction and looked towards Yi Rong. "Yi Rong, you're in second place. What question do you have to ask the Lord Master?" Yi Rong was all seriousness as he said gravely, "Teacher, my question happens to be almost the direct opposite of Big Brother's question in terms of line of thought. I've been considering, does a kingdom count as strong if its borders are endless, or if the country is prosperous and the people at peace? For a strong dynasty, even if it carves out new frontiers every day, if the people are destitute and the soldiers on the front lines suffer high casualties, what is the meaning of exhausting the troops and engaging in war like this?" Yi Dai's facial expression chilled with Yi Rong's question. Yi Rong was obviously asking this question just for the sake of asking it. Yi Dai's question had to do with uniting the 16 kingdoms, whereas Yi Rong asked what was the point in indulging in wars of aggression. No matter how one looked at this question, it was at direct odds with the question that he, Yi Dai, had asked. The honor tutor's expression was non-committal as he wasn't angered by Yi Rong's contrary question. He thought briefly, then said, "Soldiers are men as well. If soldiers and generals have no motivation and goals when fighting on the front lines, they will be unhappy. Then, such wars are meaningless. Expanding borders is not necessarily an evil. On the other hand, holding the army in check is not necessarily a good thing. The difference between good and bad is determined by the intention of the war. If expanding borders can help more people live a better life, then this war is a good one." This old man's perspective is that the purpose in expanding borders lies not in having more territory, but in helping more people live a prosperous and peaceful life. If one in a superior position loses sight of this goal, then he will lose sight of the correct direction. Yi Rong listened raptly, nodding slightly as he returned to his seat. He would need some time to absorb and digest these words. "All right, now, it's time for the owner of the first place gift to ask his questions. According to the rules, the owner can ask two questions." Danf cast her gaze on to Jiang Chen. She was a smart woman and naturally knew that this Nine Magnificence Dew wine was not something that the three had planned together. It was 100% something that this strange young fellow had cooked up. Danf was a woman who didn't easily find her curiosity piqued, but at this moment, she was quite curious about Jiang Chen. She really wanted to know just what question would this young man ask of the Lord Master? Questions of martial Tao? Or questions in other eras? Feeling Danf's eyes on him, Jiang Chen smiled faintly and inclined his body slightly, hiding behind Yi Rong very naturally. It wasn't that Jiang Chen was running away from anything. He truly didn't want to keep a high profile. What he wanted to do most at the moment was to close his eyes and rest for a bit, simulating a battle with a spirit realm practitioner. Because he was going to face Xin Wu Dao's challenge next. This matter had to do with the life and death of the Qiao brothers. Under these circumstances, Jiang Chen truly had no interest to bother himself with these things. He knew that if he asked a question, he'd be subjecting himself to all sorts of rumors and gossip. It was better to avoid these things if possible. When Tian Chao saw Jiang Chen like this, he knew that Jiang Chen had truly decided to give up his chances and wasn't putting on a show of false politeness. He said to Lin Qianli, "Qianli, you ask first." Lin Qianli also wanted to protest out of modesty, but his resolution towards martial Tao overcame his modesty in the end and he took a step out. "Honor tutor, your junior, Lin Qianli, of the Azure Heaven Southern Palace, would like to ask a question with regards to martial Tao. Your junior has constantly sought after the great perfection of 12 meridians true qi within the true qi realm. I have meditated arduously for 3 years but have never obtained it. Your junior would like to ask the honor tutor, is the great perfection of 12 meridians true qi just an insubstantial mirage in the end?" A sudden beam of shrewd light shot out from the honor tutor's eyes, shooting into Lin Qianli's heart like an arrow of unparalleled sharpness. Aren't you half-step spirit realm already? And you still cannot let go of your fixation on great perfection? There has never been such a thing as great perfection on the path of martial Tao. Perfection means there is no longer any room for improvement. You are fixated on great perfection, yet you do not know that you are already passing up the best timing to enter the spirit realm? These words were as lightning streaking amidst the dark, dim hillsides as they lit up Lin Kaiyani's world of martial Tao. Lin Kaiyani was akin to being struck by lightning in a moment as he stood there, terrified. Abruptly, the light of enlightenment shot out from his eyes as a relieved smile blossomed on his face. He bowed deeply. Many thanks for the honor tutor's blow to the head, allowing your junior to brush away the clouds and see the clear sky. The old tutor smiled faintly and said nothing else. He rather admired Lin Kaiyani's decisiveness and strong capabilities of comprehension. Junior Tian Chao. Tian Chao walked on stage next. Although Jiang Chen had said that this was a gift from all three of them, Lin Kaiyani had asked one question and Tian Chao was taking the other. Didn't this mean there were no opportunities for Jiang Chen to ask anything? Jiang Chen wasn't asking. Even the people on Yi Dai's side were faintly astonished. Lu Wuji was even cursing Jiang Chen in his heart. Jiang Chen, that fool. How could he pretend to be generous and give such a prime opportunity to someone else? He's a fool, all right. Motherfing hell. Why won't such great opportunities fall into my lap? Although Lu Wuji had just been hectored by Danf, he still maintained absolute worship and admiration towards Yi Chonglu, just like everyone else. He would even dream of having an opportunity to ask questions like this, but he knew that such a chance would never come around to him. As he saw Tian Chao walk onto stage, Lu Wuji's heart felt like it had been bitten by a viper as he was filled with jealousy. Just who the hell was Tian Chao? He'd always been someone beneath Lu Wuji's feet, someone whose status had never been able to match up to Lu Wuji. How could he swagger on stage to ask questions of the honor tutor now? Little petty men getting their wish. Lu Wuji cursed inwardly. He could only scorn a person who obtained what he desired but could not have. Danf was also slightly surprised. She'd been curious about Jiang Chen and really wanted to know what questions he'd ask. But, even though she'd waited and waited, the end result was that none of the people asking questions was Jiang Chen. In this regard, Danf's curiosity towards Jiang Chen increased even more. Tian Xiao's question naturally had to do with martial Tao. The honor tutor was obviously a teacher who taught without discrimination. No matter who it was who asked a question, he treated them all fairly and gave targeted explanations. His final answer also greatly benefited Tian Chao. When the old tutor had finished answering Tian Chao's question, First Prince Yi Dai also breathed out a long sigh of relieved comfort. This unlucky break was finally over. The segment of offering gifts concluded here. Although he was in third place, this ranking caused him to be dejected. Even so, he was fully anticipating the next segment, because Sister Danf had just mentioned that another segment would be spontaneously added after the gifts were presented. Yi Dai was rather looking forward to this segment because he had prepared long and hard for it. He'd even given no thought to the costs and had purposefully invited a disciple of the Precious Tree Sect to come just for this matter. I hope that the intelligence was correct this time, and that the additional segment Sister Danf mentioned was the item that I prepared for. If I can help the honor tutor to relieve his burdens, then I am sure that I will become his most favored student. When I ascend to the throne in future, I am sure to receive the honor tutor's support and approval. Yi Dai's eyes were full of ardent fervor as he looked at Danf with a hotly burning gaze. His heart itched to advance to the next segment. When he thought of Danf's promise, all of the blood in Yi Dai's body thrummed and boiled. Those who could help the Lord Master resolve this difficult would receive a favor from the honor tutor. After receiving a nod from the Lord Master, Danf once again came to the front of the stage and smiled demurely. Everyone, I already mentioned earlier that there will be an additional segment added after offering the gifts. According to prior agreement, whoever can help the Lord Master with his troubles in this segment will receive a favor from the Lord Master. Remember, this is a favor that the Lord Master will expend his full energy to fulfill. Everyone please rack your brains. A favor that he'll use his full energy to fulfill? My gosh. How many years has it been since the honor tutor has made a promise like this? TSK, if I could receive a favor from the honor tutor, joining even the Precious Tree Sect would be but a word from the Lord Master away. We must cherish this opportunity. Hey, even the king is likely to be jealous of whoever receives this favor. Hey, if this favor falls to me, I would hail the Lord Master as my master immediately and reside with Sister Danf. This way, hey. All sorts of thoughts and ambitions permeated the great yard in this moment.